Okay, so part two. I was going to do this as one, but my computer has this little error from time to time where it will turn around and it will... it's having Windows activation error. It keeps acting like it's going to activate it, and then it doesn't, and then it clips everything off, so it stops the video. The only way I can do something about it is to basically wipe my entire hard drive and start fresh. Which obviously I don't really want to do right now because I have a lot of stuff on it. And I have to back up a lot of my stuff. So until I do that, I have to kind of grin and bear it. But if nothing else, it kind of narrows things down. And what the hell, I make a second video. I haven't made one in a while, so I owe you guys that. I'll give you guys another video. Alright, so back to what I was saying. In the last video, I was talking about how these things are used to manipulate people. So with that, I'm going to segue on to catchphrases, a lot of stuff about how these movements really work, and if you note, and if you pay very close attention, a lot of these cult-type figures here on YouTube, which is how I'm weighing in on these into that, because you'll note there is a lot of similar mechanics that are used. These things are consistent. They know these things work because predators evolve over time to adapt to their prey. Likewise, people like Greg adapt themselves accordingly. If you pay close attention to his videos, he basically flat out says it. He changes his guys on the fly to appeal to what he thinks that you want. And then he throws in his own narrative and just kind of sneaks it in there. Kind of like when people are making a bill into a law and they just kind of sneak extra stuff around. They tend to call it fluff. They tend to call it a lot of things. So you have to be very careful when these people send their message out, because you have to kind of read between the lines and maybe even watch things a couple of times just to make sure you got all the pertinent information. And this guy is no different. He likes to kind of sneak things in there. I said this. Yeah, but what you were really saying was this, 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 and this, and you were laughing in our faces. Which, basically, he makes a living off of it. It's unsurprising that many sociopaths and many psychopaths tend to find themselves into those hallmarks. They tend to find themselves into those positions, and that's why, because they can thrive in that environment. They're people that, in general, are used to changing up that mask on the fly, and you never know who you're really dealing with. You get more than one of them together, and you really wind up having a big problem. Anyway, move it along. So, the first thing that I'm going to do before I even start this is, because I'm going to get into a little bit more about activists and movements and such, I'm going to ask a question. And I want you to keep this question in your mind, and by the end of this video, unless I get clipped off again, in which case I'll answer it in another video, I will answer the question. Okay? So, here's a question for you. Okay? Take any movement, any cause, any one that you like, keep them in your mind, okay? Any movement. Can be Black Lives Matter, can be feminists, can be PETA, can be Boy Scouts, can be Girl Scouts. Keep any cause in your mind, okay? All right. Which of these three is the worst for the cause? Which one harms the cause the most? And don't worry, I'm not going to say, oh my god, there is kind of a right answer, but don't feel badly if you don't get it right, because we all have our own damn opinions, and part of this is to kind of learn and grow and keep these things in mind. If you are a member of these movements, these are ways that you can kind of, I want to say, improve yourself. And by improve, I don't mean be a better predator than the rest. I mean shape up or ship out, because that is what we need our movements to do at this point. Shape up or ship out and stop being pawns of the very things that we claim to be against. We'll get into that another time. Alright, so here's the question. What is the worst? What harms a cause out of these three the most? Is it the person that is a member of a cause? Person that has joined the movement and is a member of it? Day-to-day operations, that sort of thing. Is it the critic? The person that says, you're doing this wrong, you're doing that wrong, you're acting like a bunch of idiots, you are a bunch of idiots. Or, last but never least, the defender of a cause. So the member, the critic, and the defender. Which one of these three is the most harmful for cause? I want you to keep that question in your mind as we're kind of turning this around, and I will explain that either at the end of the video or if it clips off in another video. Shortly afterwards. I won't leave you hanging. I'll try my best. Okay. So, let's take a look at movements in general. What do we generally look at? What should we look at? You want to get into a movement. Okay. You want to support a person. Okay. You think this particular person may be an upstanding fellow. Maybe you want to support their channel. Okay. So what do we look for? You want to look, there are things that you want to look for in with any group or organization or person, which is their funds, their donors, their critics, any bad behavior on their part, and most importantly, how is it handled? So let's kind of go down the list here. We have funds, which is not really so much as how many funds they have on hand, but how do they raise funds? How do they prefer to raise funds? Are they raising funds to help with something? Or are they raising funds because they need to fight this, this, and this? Are they using the blame game to get your money? Are they making you feel insecure or afraid to get your money? Are they telling you stuff like, this particular group is out to get you, and if you don't support us, it's going to be the end? In addition, the other thing when I say funds is how they use those funds. Where do the funds go to? I'm going to call out an Ihalaback here. You remember them. They did the feminist thing of X hours in Manhattan, which was fate. It was definitely fate. And you can kind of look at things and see, oh wait, a lot of this is really just staged and scripted. And if you pay attention to the interviews regarding that, the people there have staged, but they have changed their story a couple of times, because one moment the lady's afraid, the next moment, suddenly she's fantasizing about all the things that she was going to do with them, and due to this, these people that were coming up to her. Okay. You know, very different things here. Then there was the matter of the placement of the camera. Supposedly, the boyfriend was taking camera as he was going along, and then at other points he had a GoPro on his chest and then on his back. Unless he was walking backwards, he didn't have it on his chest. Afterwards, he then changed it to his back. Then he turns around and says, oh, wait. I waited for about a year to turn this in. It didn't take you a year to edit that video, dude. And it mattered to him so much he had to get it out. So much that he waited a year. Oh, and look, this guy has a viral media platform, which he is using this to publicize. But then we go to Ihalaback in general. They talked about spending $150 for getting items for this march, okay? And then personal retreats. I'm going to get into what personal retreats really means, but I will say this. Having help plan some of these things, it does not cost $150+ to get pens and markers, many of which the participants themselves bring. It does not cost them a bunch to have these marches. In short, they're lying to you, and they did lie to you. So where did the money go? To personal retreats. Was it for all their members? No, it was a select consortium at the very top rungs. This is usually how it works. If you're saying, oh my god, that's just like politics, well, welcome to reality, because it is exactly like politics. It is a microcosm, a smaller version of the same bullshit that we see at the top rungs. They are not there to help you, they have just become a lesser version of the very thing they claim to be against, and they count on their members being too stupid, too gullible, or too willfully ignorant and emotionally charged to ever do anything about it, let alone address it, and especially never fix it, because then that makes them look bad, and nobody ever wants to look bad, which gets back into the personal ego. They care more about their ego than your cause. And that's always been the way that it's been. And if you ever think that I'm kidding, get boots on the ground in any organization you like, and start, you'll make a checklist of the things that I'm saying, and see how well these things match up, and I think you'll find that they do match up exceedingly well, because that is what they've always been about. Okay, so we talked about funds, and use of funds, and so on. Let's move on to donors. This came up a lot during the campaigns. Because a lot of people were saying, oh, Trump's being funded by white supremacists, which they never bothered to prove. But they did prove that Hillary was taking money through a Clinton Foundation from Saudi Arabia, which punishes the rumor of LGBT with death. Hanging, throwing people off rooftops, and yet the LGBT community was largely supporting Clinton. Why? I mean, with one simple swoop, we see they are supporting a candidate that is not only not supporting them, but supported by people that are against them. They don't care. They get your money. They can play to your emotions. After that, after they've done using you, they just throw you away. That's always been how it has been. These movements are no different. They do the same thing. So donors is another one. Or the Million March that was funded by Soros, who's had his fingers in so many pies, many of them very illegal. So, look at the, if you can see publicly who their donors are, take a look at who is making these donations. Where are they getting their money from? Or as they said, always follow the money. Pre-Watergate. Always follow the money. Follow the money trail. And this applies to almost all walks of life as well. Mind you, I'm saying that this ties into people like Onision, this ties into people like, I can't really think of anybody else off the top of my head. There have been a couple notable, memorable winners on YouTube, and there are enough people. Keemstar. Keemstar is another one. Critics. Who is criticizing these people? Now, this is one thing that I often like to do. Whenever someone is being criticized, again, we're talking objective truth here, I like to see who is criticizing them, why, what they're like. If I'm on Facebook and someone is talking some smack, one of the first things I do is pull up their Facebook and, okay, what is this person about? It's going to tell me a lot about what I'm dealing with, and whether I'm dealing with someone that has a rational mindset or someone that's just a raving freaking nut job that just wants to get another like on Facebook. But it's one thing that I like to do, is look at these things and, hold on a second. So, we'll go back to Hillary versus Trump. Okay, you're decrying Hillary. What's your basis? What are you about? Why are you saying what you were saying? Okay, you are an average run-of-the-mill fellow. You're tired of the bullshit that's in office. You don't like the fact that they're calling people deplorables, making shit up about people, blaming everybody else for their mistakes and not taking any accountability, and you're really, really concerned about some of the things you've been seeing in the emails, and especially the fact that they don't take any kind of criticism, period. They get really fanatical in your face about it. Okay. Go over the Trump side of things. Why is Trump being criticized? He's not Hillary. And he's going to do this. Sources where? Oh, no, he's against immigrants. He's against immigrants. No, he's against illegal immigrants. Illegal immigrants. They're undocumented. And undocumented equals illegal. They are illegal. I am all for one for reforming the immigration. But, that does not mean that because a candidate disagrees with you or says something that you don't like, that he's coming for all the immigrants, or all the gays, or all of insert category here. Because that's not happening. It is not happening. He's preventing Muslims. No, he's preventing Muslims from certain countries that were linked to terrorism. And if you really want to get a bug up your butt, I want you to go over and point that same ire at Carter, who you didn't give a damn about when he did the same thing. Spare me your righteous indignation. Good Lord, I cannot make my words today. Sorry. Spare me your righteous indignation. Because we had 8 years of straight nonsense where somebody came up on a freaking podium and said, white people don't know how to be poor. And not one person that was concerned about racism said, there's a problem with that. That statement is racism. No, they said stuff like, they can't be racist against certain types or sexist against certain types. And they fed us this line of bullshit. When I see people like that, I go, you're full of it. Now, if I see a Trump supporter that hates Hillary just because she's a woman, obviously, I'm going to have something to say about that too, because that is equally fucked up. That is equally wrong. It's weird because in America, we have developed this mentality where we always have to pick a side. It always has to be one extreme or the other. It has to be A or B, nothing else. If you're not with us, you're against us. If you don't like this, you like that. If you're against this, you must be that. Has it ever dawned on you that you might be full of shit? And that reality just doesn't work that way, and there are other options. More than if then, like we're a bunch of faulty robots. Just saying. Not Dragon Ball, but just saying. But it's not, there is like no middle ground. There is no, you can support this person, but not be this. It's, you have, if you don't support Hillary, you're suddenly a white national, or you're sexist, you're a racist. If you don't support Trump, you're this, you're that. To be fair, a lot of the people that I see that have supported Hillary or Bernie, there is something seriously wrong with them. I'm not saying it's all of them, but a good chunk of them have had something seriously wrong about them, and they have that whole reactive mindset, mob mentality, useful, willing idiot thing going on. Which is why you hear me talk about them a lot, mainly because I'm calling them out in their bullshit. Time to get your head out of your asses, guys. You're just making things worse for yourselves. Anyway, I digress. Let's jump off of that for a second, though. Critics. There is a difference between criticism and being an asshole. You know, being an asshole is, well, you don't like this, so you're that. Criticism is, I don't like this because of this, 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 and this. And you might not agree with my opinion, but if you're going to say something about it, have something to back up your side of the story other than, you're a hater because you said something I didn't like. Critics. There you go. Okay. So, we got through that point. Now we're going on to bad behavior. This is a big one. And I will give you a good example from a situation that I found myself involved in. I did live stream. And we often went by this bar in Nashville. And if anybody from there, they'll know what I'm talking about. They should know what I'm talking about. And I'm not going to give names and such, but I will say that I had a lot of respect for the owner and for the waitresses there. They always treated me really nice, and I'm not a bar guy, okay? I don't drink. So I try not to clog up anything in the establishment, and they're trying to be nice, and here, you know, we support your cause, you know, what would you like to drink? And I'm like, oh, ma'am, I'm sorry, I don't drink, you know, I'll just take water, that's perfectly fine, I don't mean if I'm clogging up anything for your patrons. Oh, no, okay, if you wanted something to drink, like a soda or something, what would you like? You want to talk about excellent customer service? These guys had it on. And unfortunately, their business is no longer around, or they have moved, one of the two. Hopefully, I would like to say that, I would like to think that they moved in light of all of this. Because they were a really awesome establishment and really, really awesome people. And if there was anybody that deserved support from community, it was them. And the owner was kind of like this really gentle giant type. He never really got in anybody's face. He knew how to say things in just a few words. He was one of those that kind of commanded respect without having to really make any commands. But he was nice enough to let us use the speakeasy in the top to hold a lot of meetings. And, you know, if we needed to... you know, take video, Most businesses, for obvious reasons, would say, no, we don't want any part of that. Okay. But for obvious reasons, there's a lot that can go wrong. Then there's issues with filming people and, making sure that you have permission to be filmed, that sort of thing. Since we usually did it like in later hours and stuff when nobody else was around, he really didn't have a problem with it. Okay. But so needless to say, he really made some concessions for us and he was really nice to us. So you can imagine my response when I come back after a week of having a really bad case of food poisoning. And this same lady that was so nice to me is basically in tears. And they're telling me that things have gone on that have threatened the nature of their establishment and could possibly cause them to close down. I'm shocked. What's going on here? Oh, your organization did this. Come again? Whose butt do I have to light up for this? So, we had a person in there who was connected to some other shady people, and they decided one day that they were going to start taking footage of the politicians that were in there. And they were also going to publicize this on social media. Yeah, probably many of you at this point are going, oh, that's not going to go well. And it didn't. It did not. So what happened was the politicians, I'm not going to name parties or names here, they turned around and they pulled their buddies and said, you will no longer go here. Do not go here, and if you know someone, tell them they are no longer going there. We are boycotting the establishment. Great. Did we have permission? Did they have permission to do that? To film these people? No, they didn't. They basically just took video without their knowledge or consent. They believed that they could do whatever they want, and it would be sensational, and it would get views, and it would get attention, and it would get press. Any press is good press, right? A lot of these places think that, and they have to get something out there to get that attention and keep people's eyes on them. They don't realize that when you keep people's eyes on you for doing stupid shit, everything suffers. Everything suffers, including everything connected to you. So, this person's in tears. The bar owner is debating at this point whether or not he's going to allow us into his establishment again. He's still being nice to us. A lot nicer than I certainly would have been, that's for sure. And I'm sitting down going, well, what are we going to do about this? This is serious. This is really bad. We do have a obligation to make this right. And this is something that I've said a lot of times when I was in that particular organization. Funny how some people about that may talk, but, this has always been my big thing, which is to do the right thing. And I heard some of the most curious things in response. Well, we can make this person look like the fall guy. We can spin it off in this particular way. I'll be more than happy to take the fall for this. Yada, yada, yada. And I'm sitting there going, guys, what the hell is wrong with you? I come back after food poisoning to this. I didn't know when I was so well off. You guys are looking for scapegoats and excuses. We have a guy that has done nothing but good to us, that is going to potentially lose his job, his livelihood, because of actions of our organization. We need to do something about this, make it right, make some sort of public apology, something to smooth things over. Our community went to bat for us. This is where we go to bat for our community. And of course, they basically piddle-paddled around the whole bloody thing. And this wasn't the only time that something like this has happened. This is one of the more serious times. But they acted like it was a big deal, and people that, if you're preaching responsibility, oh, well, you're just being hateful, you're just being that, you shouldn't air dirty laundry, you shouldn't talk about our dirty laundry, we should just let it slide and, let things boil over and hope for the best. This is a very common thing that happens in movements. Let the problem fix itself, and it will sort itself out. This is something you will hear very often. And it's bullshit. Because no problem in human history has ever sorted itself out. No problem person has ever sorted themselves out. In order for things to change, there needs to be a reason to change. And now that bar is no longer here. I'm still not very happy about that one. And to the owner and the patrons and the waitresses that work there, I really do wish them the best, and I hope that things have improved for them since then. Because that's one of those things that still bothers me about that to that day, the fact that they didn't care. These people were so nice to them, and it was just like they were something to be used and discarded, and they didn't honestly care. They may tell you that they cared, but they're liars. Not that that's a new thing either, but... Again, so... Bad behavior. And how it is handled. I have to segue 2 points at once. There was an issue where people were talking about, money disappearing that had been used to buy drugs with. Or how a large sum of donation money had suddenly disappeared. No trace. These are very important things. But you to hear these conversations, you hear them doing their best to kind of sweep it under the rug. Forget the fact that how did this happen and how can we prevent it? Forget the fact that whoever was in charge of the money, we need to move them out of that position because clearly something is not getting done and we need to make sure it's in hands that can properly handle what we have been given. Nope, we're just going to let this thing sort itself out. The problem will fix itself. It's nothing to worry about. I'm sitting here, guys. The hell? What is wrong with you? You guys are actually saying this is okay. And there are some people, because there's always this group within any movement where they are the druggies. They just want to get high. They'll make up any number of excuses and say, oh, well, you know, this has this beneficial cause and that beneficial cause. But after all is all said and done, what do you see them doing? They drop all pretenses and go to getting high. And you'll see that in any cause, too, because they're always in there. We had a number of really messed up druggy type people in there that couldn't see light of day worth squat, but they were really eloquent and they were really good with their charisma. Again, adapting the predator for the prey. They care about getting high, and they're going to do anything to get high. And if that means they have to adapt themselves and their mannerisms to seem like a bright, wonderful person to you to separate you from their money, or you from your money, so they can get what they want, then they'll do that. They will be a nice, smiling person to you, or if it's more profitable to be an asshole to you, they'll be that too. That's the reality of what these people are really like. Hate to break it to you. That's exactly what it is. But, again, so what was the response to that? Oh my god, this person's saying we need to be accountable. He's a threat. He's a security risk. We need to do something about it. We need to censor him. So let me get this straight. You guys let someone walk away with a lot of donation money. You don't know where it went to. You don't know how it happened. There was someone that was using donation money to buy drugs with, which some of you are okay with, and I'm supposedly the threat. I'm sitting here telling you this needs to be fixed because it will eventually get out, and when it does, it's going to cause you a problem. But I'm the threat. Okay. And again, bad behavior and how it's handled. We look back at Greg, for instance, and his bad behavior when it comes to the women and such. How is it handled? Oh, well, they're haters. You know, they're just jealous. They're doing this and that to get views. You hear these excuses enough, and you can kind of make a list, and you don't even need them to make a response, because you can just look at that list and go, oh, check. Oh, there's the hater one. There's the you're just doing it to get views. There's the you're just jealous of my success. It's like you go to work at a center and they have like the scripting. It's basically scripting for sociopaths. Now there's a trying to catchphrase for you, scripting for sociopaths. And if you've heard it enough, you don't even need them to make a response because you can just make the response for them. You could make an auto generator for the response, and that's basically what you're going to get every time. It's just going to be a simplified version of whatever bullshit they feel like spouting this week. Okay. So we've gotten into funds, donors, critics, bad behavior, and how it's handled. Now we're going to look at target base. Target base. Who do these sorts look at? Movements, sociopaths, frauds, people like Greg and Laney. What type of people do they look at and why? Why do they do it? Actually, you know what? This video is drawing on a little bit long. I'll go ahead and put that in the next one. Don't worry, I forgot about, I haven't forgot about the, what's the worst for the cause? That will be coming up. I'm just going to wind up making a couple of videos, so that's coming up next.